Previously on Soul Food.
Look at your life. You got that fly car and you make a lot of money.
You told him you make a lot of money?
I told him I work hard.
Your life is tight. And you didn't go to college.
Max is gonna kill me.
I hope all this sweating you've been doing, waiting for me to whip your butt, has made you realize lying to me is always the wrong choice.
Yeah.
Good. Now go get the belt.
What?
You said you put away some money for Jeremiah. How'd you get it?
It was a payoff for delivering some stuff.
How much?
25 G's. I'm gonna put it in a savings account a little bit at a time.
So you'd rather have partners who are ass kissers than someone who brings in multi-million dollar clients, then convinces a federal court to take jurisdiction on a case that everyone thought was dead? I didn't make partner because I did the right thing the wrong way.
Had to go to the store.
I thought you hired an assistant manager to open up in the morning.
I did, but I still gotta make sure he does it right, at least for a while.
Oh, and by the way, there's an extra $5,000 in the account. Do you know anything about it?
Yeah, it's Jay's. I'll put a little in at a time. Draws less attention that way. Later, we can withdraw it and start his college fund.
Don't you think you could have talked to me about this first?
Sorry, I've been busy. I guess I forgot.
You forgot. That's it?
Why are you on my ass? I mean, you've done lots of things without talking to me first. Besides, this ain't about you and me. This is about Jay's future.
This is about you disregarding my feelings by not talking to me.
Did you talk to me before you decided to go back to work? Or before putting me out?
You know what, Lem? I gotta go to work. Don't forget to drop the baby off at Max's.
How could I forget to drop the baby off?
Goodbye, Lem.
Get up, my Nubian prince.
Mom, it's no school today, remember? It's Teacher's Day.
Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean you don't have to get up.
Can I get up later?
Ahmad, get up and get your shower. Your schoolwork for the day will be emailed within the hour.
Emailed?
Mm-hmm. I spoke to your teacher about a half hour ago.
Mom, I'd be scared to listen to anything Miss Montgomery told you if I were you. A lot of us think she's a practicing witch.
Mm-hmm. One, two.
All right.
Thank you.
Mom, can I go to Laser Universe for Casey and Reggie later?
Ahmad, you know I don't want you running around with a laser pistol pretending to shoot people. What kind of fun is that?
Mom, please.
No.
Man, this isn't fair. The teachers are out having fun. Why shouldn't we?
Ahmad, a retreat is not a picnic. Those teachers are working.
Why can't I just have the day off?
Because I said so. Now, if you don't get up and get your butt in gear, you can have this conversation with my belt.
I am so tired of hearing about her belt. I'm tired of being threatened with her belt, and I'm tired of being told to find her belt. One day I might take my belt and whoop her.
Hello.
Any chance of me getting a cut?
Well, actually, you know, we're all booked up right now, but I could probably fit you in tomorrow.
Oh, well, thanks, but my show is tonight. I need to look presentable.
Show? Are you a musician?
Artist.
What kind of art do you do?
Well, some people call it outsider art. I call it folk art.
Folk art? Like the kind of stuff hanging in the House of Blues made out of Coke cans?
Exactly.
Okay, I love that stuff.
Oh, it's good to know. I'm Roy Johnson.
Bird.
My wife, Rhonda, is a customer of yours.
Rhonda, how is she? You know, last time I talked to Rhonda... Well, never mind. Things have obviously gotten better.
Yeah, well, we went through a rough patch, but we're all right now.
Good. Listen, tell Rhonda I said hello.
Oh, you'll probably get a chance to do that yourself. She says she's gonna call you a little later.
Oh, good. I miss Rhonda. So listen, maybe I can fit you in at the end of my day. You think you might be able to come around 6?
Good deal.
Hello?
Hey, son.
Hi, Dad.
What's wrong?
None.
Nah, Ma, if nothing was wrong, you wouldn't be trying to play me with this fake sadness.
Ah, if something's on your mind, speak up.
Okay. It's Teacher's Day, and Mom took the girls and Jay to run errands, and I'm stuck here to do 1,000 years of homework.
Oh, that's a lot of homework. Hey, look, I tell you what. I'll come and pick you up, and you can hang out with your old man and do your homework here.
Okay.
Good, good.
All right, bye.
Can I help you?
Yeah, is Bird around?
Yeah, she's in the back. She'll be out in a minute.
Thank you.
Well, look who just strolled in my salon like it hasn't been 2 months since I've seen her.
Hi, Bird.
How you doing?
Good.
Where have you been?
Well, you know my little sister started her own braiding business, so I'm her number one guinea pig.
Oh, and it's cute. But just like that, my best tipping customer gone. Hey, Roy stopped by. Thanks for the referral.
So I guess you know we're together. He came back after a month. Something about not being able to live without me.
Oh. Listen, I'm really happy for you. And if you ever need to talk...
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Okay.
Well, I better go.
All right.
I'm gonna let my sister see if she can make these braids even tighter.
Okay. It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
All right.
Take care.
Okay.
Hey, Dad, why so serious?
Same reason you're serious. Got work to do. Gotta make sure Chadway Tona's around when you kids are grown.
Hey, Kelly and Brooke ain't nothing but girls. They ain't never gonna be able to drive these trucks.
You know, girls can do anything boys can do. At least that's what you better say when your mother's around.
All right. Hey, Dad. How did you get your homework when your teachers went on retreat? I mean, I know you didn't have email or anything.
Yeah, and we didn't have retreats either. The only time my teachers didn't show up was when, if it was snow day. Man, kids used to pray for snow day.
Oh, God, please let it snow, please.
And if it did, me and my boys would go sledding, tubing, build snow forts, and have a huge snowball fight.
Now, that sounds dope.
Yeah, yeah. Ahmad, you know what? It would have been different if I had a real opportunity to learn. You know, I wouldn't pass that up to play around in the snow.
Dad, don't try to play me with that opportunity speech. I mean, if you want me to take education seriously, just say that.
Oh, so you're gonna use my own words against me now, huh?
Yep.
Chadway Tone?
Yes.
No problem. You know, I'll be right there.
Big rig overturned. It's gonna take a while. You wanna stay here or you wanna go home?
I guess I'll go home. I'm not finished anyway.
All right. I get that.
Mom. Mom, I'm home. Hello? Are you guys still going to Laser Universe?
Dad's gone. Mom's gone. Why shouldn't I go?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Because Mom will kill me. That's why.
What time are you guys going? All right. I'm down. Hey, but I can only stay for a little while.
Big Mama always said being afraid isn't a reason not to do something.
All right. I'll meet you guys there. All right, bye.
I really appreciate you fitting me in.
Oh, it is not a problem. You know, I love this shirt.
Oh, thank you. You know, my father's Cuban. See, I remember when nobody wore these but old men. Now every yuppie that's ever heard of Cuba smoking a cigar got to have one.
Okay. You know, I bought one for my son, and it just looks so sweet on him.
Oh, I bet it does.
Oh, can you excuse me for a minute? I just need to take care of this, but I'm gonna get you to that opening.
Sure.
Everything all right?
No, I need to talk to you.
What's this?
It is a cashier's check for $5,000.
I thought we already talked about this.
No, we didn't. That's how the money wound up in the account in the first place. Now, I told you I don't want to have anything to do with your dirty cash.
Hey.
Hey, Roy.
Hey, baby. Hey, weren't you gonna meet me down at the House of Blues?
Yeah, but I found something that made me want to see you now.
Yeah? What's that?
A receipt for the Hilltop Motel. It was in your pocket.
Baby, baby, what did we say about this snooping thing? Listen, if you're never gonna trust me, you're just never gonna trust me. But don't be bringing your insecurities up in here like this.
Don't try to make me feel stupid, Roy. I hate it when you do that.
Well, then stop doing what you're doing. I'm trying to get a haircut, and you're embarrassing me.
Okay. I'll just go wait over there and read a magazine, and we'll talk when you're finished, because I sure wouldn't want to embarrass you.
Listen.
Okay, I heard you out. Now you listen to me. This money...
I do not care what you do with that money, as long as it does not involve me or my child.
Our child.
Whatever, Lem. You are the one who screwed up. And now you want to come around here making decisions about my checkbook, dropping by anytime you please, talking about I should figure my shit out? Well, guess what, Lem? I have figured my shit out. That's why we're not together. And that is why you have no right to put that money in my account.
Son.
He's here, isn't he?
No. When I talked to you earlier, you said you were on your way to pick him up.
I did pick him up, and I brought him back home at 5.
Well, I've been here since 5:15, Kenny, and it's almost 6:30.
If he went to Laser Universe...
But I thought you told him not to go to that place.
I did tell him that. But if he didn't think I was coming home till later, he probably thought he could just be slick and sneak out.
You know, if he did, I'm gonna whip his butt for sure.
Well, not if I get to him first.
Well, there ain't gonna be anything left of him when I get there. Max, give me the address of Laser Universe.
Later for this.
I'm going down to Laser Universe and pick his butt up right now.
Thank you.
Thanks. I'm going down there. And if I find him...
I ain't getting no more whoopings.
Your son is getting absolutely beside himself. I can't believe this.
Bird, you need me for anything?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
You want these blinds closed?
Yeah, would you please?
Good night, Bird.
Rhonda, can I get you anything?
Don't waste your time, Bird.
What did he say?
I didn't hear him say anything. So you guys must really be looking forward to that opening, huh?
No.
Okay.
Rhonda, why don't you leave?
Why don't you stop cheating on me, Roy?
Okay, why don't we both just calm down?
So you found a motel receipt, and now I'm supposed to be cheating on you. Now, I paid for that room for my brother, but I'm sure you're going to insist that it was for me, just like you insist that I'm sleeping with every woman you see me talk to.
All righty, see? We're all done. Now, why don't you two go find a nice, quiet place to discuss this?
It's quiet here.
Rhonda, you know this should not be going down here.
You know what? You need to mind your own business right now.
See, now you know what I know. She's crazy.
I'm not crazy, Roy! God, you need to stop saying that.
What you gonna do if I don't? Are you gonna throw another sculpture in my head? Or maybe try and run me over again? You know what? I got a better idea. Why don't you stay here and put on your little show, and I'll go to my opening alone. Bird, I'm sorry about
that's
this.
Right. That's okay, thank you.
Roy.
Move, Rhonda.
No, Roy, sit down.
Okay, you need to leave.
See, I told you she was crazy.
No, she's tired.
Hey,
Rhonda, you need to put that gun away. Is that real?
Look, I'm sorry, Bird, but I don't know how else to get in the loop.
Okay, no, because that is not going to help this situation.
Look, you don't know shit about my situation. You know what? You need to sit down and shut up. Go!
Hi, Ahmad.
Hey. I hope you don't mind me stopping by. You said I couldn't in time.
Everything cool?
Yeah. I just came to watch the soccer game.
You guys don't have cable?
It's out.
Well, let me call your parents and tell them mine's working just fine.
No!
Okay. Calm down. I won't call.
Thanks.
You hungry?
A little.
Come on, eat. You like steak?
Yeah.
Rhonda, I have a little baby at home who needs me. And right now, my sister's probably worried sick, wondering why it's taking me so long to come and get him.
Why'd you stop loving me?
I never stopped loving you. I just can't deal with your jealousy anymore, Rhonda. I don't want to live my life like that.
Bird!
Who's that? Who is that? He'll go away. I don't know.
Bird!
Shh, 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 shh. I have to get there. It's probably my sister. She's gonna need to... I need to tell her that.
She'll just think you're busy. No answering phones.
Okay, listen. That is my husband. He's the only one who has a key. Lem!
Rhonda!
Lem!
Baby, come out!
Baby, you okay?
I know. You okay? I'm gonna see
you. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down.
Don't move. Don't move. Just stay still, okay? I'll figure this out. I will.
Listen, I'm sure somebody heard this. Baby, this is serious now. Baby, put the gun down before this goes too far. Look, the police.
Roy, just shut up!
Please. Just. Everyone just be quiet for a little while, okay?
Jay?
Don't tell me he's getting out of the car real slow, putting off what's coming to him for as long as he can.
He wasn't at Lazy Universe, but he had been. I talked to Reggie's mom, and she told me that her husband picked up the boys and probably took them for burgers after.
Well, why the hell didn't somebody's parents call and ask if it was okay with us?
Maxine, you can't be mad at those parents. I mean, you don't know what lie Ahmad told to convince them he could hang out. Besides, they know the truth now. And I told Sheila to call us once Reggie, Casey, or Ahmad shows up. Baby, come here.
All right, I'm just gonna calm down.
Calm down.
And finish cooking.
Finish cooking.
I don't know why all of a sudden I got really nervous. Like maybe something might really be wrong with him. You know, like maybe he isn't safe.
Oh, baby. Everything's gonna be all right. Okay? What you cooking?
You okay?
I'm fine. I'm just trying to figure out how to get us out of this bullshit.
When this first started happening, I was just so glad that you weren't here.
Why?
Because if anything were to happen to me, then, you know, at least Jay would have his father.
Everything is gonna be okay, Bird.
Lem, you don't know that.
Okay, I can fix this. I can fix this. I can fix this. Okay.
I mean, I know my sisters will look after him, but I also know how much a boy needs his father.
Jay needs both of his parents.
Did you talk to your mother today?
Yes. Look, don't talk to me. I'm trying to think here.
What are you thinking about?
Thinking about the first time I held Jay in my arms at the hospital.
I just kept staring at him. Promising him and God that I'd be the best father I could be. Everything I didn't have growing up.
Remember, I cried when I heard you say that. It was for the first time I realized how much your childhood affected you.
When my pops left, I remember feeling like I was just gonna be numb. Make my heart hard so nobody could ever hurt me again. I was like, fuck everybody. I was doing pretty good, too. Until you messed me up.
How did I mess you up?
Being beautiful and smart. And so damn cool. No matter what I did, you'd always give me another chance.
Yeah, I did, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
That's why I had to let you go, Lem. I felt like I did everything I could, and you still went back to your old life.
Damn it.
Game's over. Post-game interviews are over.
Now you gotta call your parents, man.
Okay. Okay, I'll go somewhere else.
Where else are you gonna go at this hour? Come on, man, let's talk about this. Come over here. What's up?
I ran away.
What?
I had to. I went to Laser World after my mom told me I couldn't. And she's gonna whip me if I go back home.
Whip you, huh?
Yeah, whip me. And I'm tired of it. You know what I mean?
Kinda. I didn't exactly get spanked when I was growing up.
Never?
Nah, my parents didn't believe in that. We had timeouts.
Timeouts? I heard of those. Some of my friends get those at Lakeside Prep.
I had so many timeouts. It was ridiculous.
Yeah, that's gotta be way better than a stinging butt. But I'm too old to get whippings anyway.
You ever tell them that?
You crazy? I like living.
So they still treat you like a kid, huh?
Yep.
I can tell you from experience, that never changes. My dad is still on me for being a delivery guy.
Damon, you're smart. Don't throw your life away, Damon.
Yeah, I get that all the time. You're smart, Ahmad. Don't throw your life away, Ahmad. You got all these great opportunities.
Why do they do that? Always tell us about opportunities. Yeah. Hey, you know what? You should call your aunts. Tell them how you feel.
What for? They tell each other everything.
I know, but, you know, don't snooze on the closeness. Nothing's wrong with a family that isn't scared to love each other.
Then how come you don't go to Sunday dinner?
I'm gonna call your Aunt Terry. I'm sure she'll help you out.
Wish I could call and check on Jay.
He's with Maxine, so you know he's fed dry and happy.
You know, Lem, leaving you was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. I mean, as soon as you walked out the door, all my insecurities came back.
You? Insecure?
Yeah. I guess it's from all those years of watching my mother deal with my father's twisted lifestyle. She was definitely the giver in the relationship. She was so good to him. And I am my mother's daughter. So I grew up looking for attention from guys so that I could prove that I could be good to them. Which is why I let you get away with so much, because I figured, well, I'm not gonna complain. And if I'm not nice, he won't love me anymore.
That's a trip. How come you never told me that before?
I don't know. I guess I'm just now figuring it out.
I'm just thinking somebody ought to throw a rope around us and sell tickets to the exhibit. But it's been done before. It was at the Ballard Art Collective years ago. They called it the holdup.
I remember that.
You remember how good things used to be between us?
I do. I knew you were the one the first time I saw you.
I was so scared to step to you, girl. I mean, I was just a struggling artist. You were this together businesswoman.
What kind of artist are you?
Oh, I do outside traditional art, but I'm on the inside. I got lucky. Rich folks started digging my work. My career took off.
What kind of materials do you use?
You know, mud, old tin cans, oil, canvas, Firestone tires, shredded Ford Explorers, paper clips. Rhonda discovered me.
Oh, Rhonda, is that right?
Oh, yeah. You know, Rhonda manages artists. She's the first one to tell anybody who'd listen how inspired she thought my work was.
All right, that's enough fun with Dick and Jane.
Okay, Barry. All right.
Hello?
Hey, Max, it's Terry.
Did you get my messages? I can't find Ahmad. I tried calling you at work on the cell, at home.
Max, I found him.
Oh, thank God.
He found him. Hello? Hello? Hey, is he with you?
He's at Damon's. I'm on my way to get him right now. I'll bring him right home.
Whoa, why is he with Damon?
Damon said something about him not wanting to go home because he didn't want to get a whipping.
Oh, so he think it's going to be easier on him if he hides, huh?
I don't know what he was thinking.
Yeah, me either. You know, thank you, T.
See you in a bit.
All right.
Whoa! Bang. Bang.
You don't have to do this. Please, baby, don't do this.
Why? What do you care? You don't want me.
Listen, baby, if you put the gun down, we can go home and talk about this. I promise you.
And how long are you gonna stay? You walked out on me twice. Why should I believe you're not gonna walk out on me again?
Listen. If you give me your word, I'll give you mine.
Give me my word on what?
I'll come home for good. If you promise to get some anger management counseling.
Roy, I'm tired. I'm scared. I'm hurt. Frustrated. But I am not angry. I am...
Okay. It's my mistake. Okay?
Hey.
Hey, T.
Hey, Kenny. Hey, Max.
Hey.
You all right?
I'm all right now.
I told Ahmad that he can't run away from his problems, and he needs to share whatever it is that's bothering him.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go back to work.
Thank you, baby.
Mm-mm.
Thanks a lot, T.
Okay. It's gonna be okay.
You know, we were really worried about you.
Thank you.
You know, I have to say, I'm very disappointed. I mean, we just talked about how you need to speak up. Instead, you decide to disobey us and then try to run away from your mistakes. You know, I think that's what disappoints me the most. What?
Aunt Terry said be succinct and rational. I guess succinct means scared because that's what I am.
I understand why you guys are angry. You have every right to be.
But if you give me a chance to explain, there are some things that's been eating at me that I think I have the right to express.
Oh. Oh, you think you have rights? Hmm? Well, you don't have the right to worry us to death.
But...
You know, Ahmad, go to your room. And I'll be up in a minute with my belt.
But...
You heard your father. Go to your room.
No.
What?
I said no. I'm not getting any more whippings.
You know, Ahmad, go to your room. I'm scared to even look at you right now. If I have to say it again, it's not gonna be pretty up in here.
Maybe
I think I need to go on a walk.
Don't answer it.
I have to get that. I'm sure that's my sister. I'm 2 hours late picking up my baby.
You're obviously running late.
No,
this wasn't supposed to happen. I just wanted you to listen to me. Shit! Oh, shit. Roy, just answer that, okay? And just tell them I need 5 minutes.
Hello? Yeah, this is Roy Johnson. No, we're fine. Everybody's fine. Look, we could just have 5 more minutes. Please. He wants to talk to you.
No, I need 5 minutes. 5 minutes, give me 5 minutes!
Please. Just 5 more minutes. I'm sure.
Roy. Do you love me?
I told you I do.
And you meant what you said about going home if I go to therapy?
Absolutely.
Rhonda. You remember the last time you were in here? You told me how special your relationship was. Well, if the two of you really love each other, I'm sure it can be that way again.
It's so hard, Bird. It's so hard to trust things. To believe he's not gonna fool around on me again.
Look, that was 5 years ago, baby. I've been true to you ever since.
Listen, I know how hard it is. When you lose trust, it's the hardest thing in the world to get back. But if you are not open for it, then you can be sure you're not gonna get there again.
I don't wanna. I can't.
Then give us one more chance to make this work. I know we can.
You do?
Yeah. Up.
I love you, Roy.
I love you too, Rhonda.
It's okay now, baby. It's okay.
Bird calls. She's on her way. Pick up Jay. She sounded kind of funny.
Is she?
I love you, Kenny Chadway.
Thank you, baby. You know what? I do not want you walking the streets at night by yourself like that.
It's too dangerous out there.
I had to find my man.
Max, I'm serious.
Besides, Miss Jenkins was happy to come from next door to watch the kids.
Yeah, I know it gave us a chance to talk, but it's just too dangerous for you to be out like that.
All right, I hear you. I definitely don't want to worry you.
All right. And thank you for reminding me that we raised our son to be independent and proud.
Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why we can't be mad at him for becoming exactly what we wanted him to be.
We need to talk to you.
Okay. We've decided that the Chadway house is one full of intelligent, thinking, responsible people. And everyone in it is going to be treated accordingly.
And we wanted to be clear. This is about respect, Ahmad. Everything that we do for you is because we love you.
Mm-hmm. And from now on, you will be free to speak your mind.
And no more belts.
What about the switch?
Okay, well, you're too old for that, too.
Thank you. I just wanted to be able to talk, but you guys told me to be quiet and do as I'm told.
Well, that won't be happening anymore. You can ask all the questions you want. That's what smart people do.
Now, let's talk about privileges. Every time you get out of line, it'll be your privileges that'll be taken away. Now, for that little trip that you took downtown to Damon's, well, all of your privileges are taken away for 2 weeks.
What do you mean, all?
Well, all means all, son. No TV, no stereo, no PlayStation, no basketball, and no telephone.
And you will come straight home from school, do your homework, read to your little sisters, and then go to bed. Understand?
I might as well be dead.
Ahmad, your mother is talking to you. Say something.
Can I just have a whooping? Okay.
Yo-yo. Thank you. All right.
I don't believe it. No TV, no music or PlayStation. I can't do nothing for 2 weeks. How come they treat me like I'm smart and I end up feeling stupid?
Thank you so much for driving me home.
No problem. I'll pick you up tomorrow if you want me to and take you back to your car.
You know, I never did ask you why you came back to the shop.
I hated the way I left. I just wanted to try one more time to communicate. Like two people who have to raise a child they both love. When are you going to tell your sisters what happened?
This weekend. If I call them tonight, they'll just want to come over, talk all night, make sure we're okay. I can't. I'm done. I'm exhausted.
All right, I guess I'll get going.
Lem.
Yeah?
When the baby gets a little bit older, I want you to tell him all about your life, about how you grew up, how your father left, and why your mother was who she was.
Bro, I don't even like remembering that stuff myself. Why would I share it with Jay?
So that he can know why you're the man you are.
Let me think about it.
Lem.
Yeah?
Maybe you can sleep in Maxine's room tonight.
What?
Just, you know. You know, you could surprise Jay in the morning, and I would feel much better with you here.
Okay, I'll stay.
Thank you.
Thanks for taking care of Ahmad.
No problem. You know I love that kid. Plus, he gave me a chance to see you.
Can I ask you a question?
Of course.
Are we broken up?
Let's see. Until tonight, we haven't spoken for a week because we had this real ugly fight. Then I told you I loved you, and then you walked out on me.
Okay. If we're still together, would you come over here? Because I can't sleep. And I know that I could if you were here.
So, you want to use me because of my ability to make you fall into a deep slumber?
Yes.
Okay, I'm coming right over. Can I ask you a question?
Of course.
Did you, talk to your sisters about that partnership thing yet?
Can we not talk about that?
So you haven't.
Will you please just come to me, Mr. Carter?
Okay, I'm coming over, Miss Joseph. I'll see you in a minute.
Thank you.